5-minute bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, Leland Stanford. Leland Stanford, born March 9, 1824 in Waterfleet, New York, is a controversial figure of the 19th century. His rise to become a brutal and ruthless businessman who sought to achieve his goals without scruples was exemplary in American industrial and railroad history. Stanford, raised on a farm, learned early the importance of hard work. After graduating from Albany College, he began working and started a successful wholesale business with his brothers. These experiences laid the foundation for his future ventures. His life was to take a decisive turn when he joined the 1850 California Gold Rush. In California, Stanford opened a mining supply store and quickly realized the potential of the railroad industry. As a co-founder of the Central Pacific Railroad, he played a leading role in the construction of the Transcontinental Railroad. In the process, his unscrupulous side emerged as he exploited his employees and enforced strict working conditions to achieve his goals. While his contribution to the development of the railroad network cannot be denied, his aggressive approach to business should not be overlooked either. Stanford was considered an astute strategist who stopped at nothing to protect his personal and financial interests. His willingness to cross ethical lines to increase his wealth led to fierce controversy. The tragic death of his only son, Leland Stanford Jr., at the age of 15, led to the founding of Stanford University as a memorial. This institution was intended not only to provide education, but also to be a platform for research and progress, a testament to the complex relationship between ruthless success and philanthropic contrition. Today, Stanford University is an internationally renowned institution of higher learning. It is considered one of the best universities in the world, if not the best. Numerous graduates have gone on to become billionaires in neighboring Silicon Valley, including Larry Page and Sergey Brin of Google, as well as Reed Hastings of Netflix and, of course, Phil Knight, the founder of Nike. Stanford owned two wineries. One of them, the Great Vina Ranch in Tehama County, California, had the largest vineyard in the world at the time, covering more than 14 square kilometers. He bequeathed this vineyard to Stanford University. Stanford's political commitment was evident during his tenure as governor of California from 1862 to 1863, when he championed education reforms and infrastructure projects, but his tenure also served to advance his own agenda. During Stanford's time as governor of California, a debate arose over the introduction of standard time. Stanford supported the idea of regulating time using clocks to coordinate rail traffic. He believed that this would increase efficiency, and this contributed to the later introduction of standard time. In 1885 until his death in 1893, Stanford served as U.S. Senator for the state of California in Washington. During this time, however, he remained head of his giant railroad company, the Central Pacific Railroad. On June 21, 1893, Leland Stanford passed away. His estate of approximately $50 million would be equivalent to a fortune of approximately $1.8 billion at the present time. Leland Stanford is buried in the Stanford Mausoleum on the campus of Stanford University. The Stanford Mausoleum is located near Stanford Memorial Church and is the final resting place of Leland Stanford, his wife Jane Stanford, and their son, Leland Stanford Jr. Well, so much for Leland Stanford, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.